Hi, I'm Samir, and now we will learn a trick to multiply two numbers called one-line multiplication. It is generally used in cases where no other more elegant trick can be used. Here, the idea is to understand the process first, and then we will proceed to see how we can write down the answer in one line. Pay extra attention to each and every step. Please notice carefully the movement of arrows to understand the flow better. Let's begin. Let us use 26 into 34 as an example. Here, the answer would be in three parts. We will begin by third part, which is the product of 4 and 6, giving us 24. The second part would be the sum of cross products of 2 and 4 and 6 and 3, giving us 2 into 4, 8, and adding to it would be 3 into 6, 18, giving us a total of 26. And the first part would be the product of 2 into 3, giving us 6. Please note that the number of digits in second and third part would be 1. So, the extra 2 in the third part will be moved to the second part, making it 26 plus 2, 28, leaving behind 4 in the third part. Similarly, the extra 2 in the second part will be moved to the first part, making it 6 plus 2, 8, leaving behind 8 in the second part. Now we can finally get the answer as 8, 8, 4. Having understood the process, let us proceed to see how we can write down the answer in one line. For this, we will have two boxes. One would be called the answer box and the other would be called the carryover box. The answer box would contain the final digits of the answer, whereas the carryover box will show the calculation that goes on in our mind to arrive at the answer. We can begin from the right hand side. 4 into 6, 24. We can put down 4 in the answer box and carry over 2. Next step would be to multiply 4 with 2 and add to it the carryover, making it 8 plus 2, 10. Now, to this we will add 3 into 6, 18, which will give us 18 plus 10, 28. Now we can put down 8 in the answer box and keep 2 in the carryover box. Finally, we'll multiply 3 and 2 to get 6, and to this we'll add the carried over 2, giving us 8. Now we can write down our final answer as 8, 8, 4. Having understood the process for 2-digit numbers, let us try to extend it to 3-digit numbers. Again, our aim would be first to understand the process and then try to write down the answer in one line. Here, the answer would have 5 parts. Let us begin by 5th part, which should be 7 into 3, giving us 21. 4th part would be 2 into 3 equal to 6 plus 4 into 7 equal to 28, giving us a total of 34. For the 3rd part, it would be the product of 5 and 3, which will give us 15. To this, we will add 2 into 4, which is 8, and then add 8 into 7, 56. Now adding all this, we will get 79. Now for the second part, we will have the product of 5 and 4 giving us 20. And to this, we will add the product of 8 and 2, 16, giving us total of 36. And finally, for the first part, we will have 8 into 5 equal to 40. Please note that the number of digits in the second, third, fourth and fifth part each should be 1. So beginning from 5th part, we'll have to move the extra 2 to the 4th part, making it 34 plus 2, 36, and leaving behind 1 in the 5th part. Now again, the extra 3 in the 4th part will be moved to the 3rd part, giving us 79 plus 3, 82 in the 3rd part and leaving behind 6 in the 4th part. Again, the extra 8 in the 3rd part will be moved to the 2nd part, making the 2nd part as 36 plus 8, 44 and leaving behind 2 in the 3rd part. Finally, the extra 4 in the 2nd part will be moved to the 1st part, therefore giving us 44 in the 1st part and leaving behind 4 in the 2nd. Now we can club all these and write down our final answer as 4, 4, 4, 2, 6, 1. Let us proceed to write down the answer in one line. Again, we will have two boxes. One would be called the answer box and the other would be called the carryover box. The answer box would contain the final digits of the answer, whereas the carryover box will show the calculation that goes on in our mind to arrive at the answer. We can begin by multiplying 7 and 3, giving us 21. We can put down 1 in the answer box and take 2 to the carryover box. Next, we'll multiply 2 and 3 to get 6. And to this, we will add the carryover 2, making it 8. To this, we add 4 into 7, 28, giving us 28 plus 8, 36 as a total for this part. We can put down 6 in the answer box and take 3 as carryover. For the next part, we'll start with 5 into 3, 15. To this, we'll add the carryover 3, making it 18. To this, we'll also have to add 2 into 4, 8, making it 26. And finally, we add 7 into 8, 56, giving us a total of 82 for this part. So we can put 2 in the answer box and carry 8 to the next part, which will begin by multiplying 5 and 4, which gives us 20. And adding to it the carryover 8 makes it 28. To this, we will also add 8 into 2, 16, making it 28 plus 16, 44. Now, we can put down 4 in the answer box and carry the remaining 4 to the carryover box for the final part. We can now multiply 5 and 8, giving us 40. To this, we add the final carryover 4 for the last time, giving us 44. Now, we can write down our final answer as 4, 4, 4, 2, 6, 1. Let us now try one more example to see how good our understanding is. We will write down only the answer this time. So let us try 624 into 753. Let us proceed to write down the answer in one line. Again, we will have two boxes, the answer box and the carryover box, and the answer would have 5 parts. We'll begin from right hand side by multiplying 4 and 3, giving us 12. We can put down 2 in the answer box and take 1 to the carryover box. Next, we'll multiply 2 and 3 and get 6. And to this, we'll add the carryover 1, making it 7. Now, to this, we add 5 into 4 equal to 20, making it 20 plus 7, 27. We can put down 7 in the answer box and take 2 as the carryover. For the next part, we'll start by 6 into 3, 18. To this, we'll add the carryover 2, making it 20. Now we'll add 2 into 5, 10 to it, making it 10 plus 20, 30. Finally, we will add 7 into 4, 28 to it, giving us 58 as total for this part. So we can put 8 in the answer box and carry over 5 to the next part, which will begin by multiplying 6 and 5, giving us 30. And to it, we will add the carry over 5, making it 35. And finally, we'll add 7 into 2, 14, making it 14 plus 35 equal to 49. Now, we can put down 9 in the answer box and carry 4 to the carryover box for the final part. We can finally multiply 6 and 7, giving us 42. And to this, we'll add the final carryover 4 for last time, giving us 46. Now, we can write down our final answer as 4, 6, 9, 8, 7, 2. If you have liked our tutorials, please subscribe to our channel to be updated on our latest releases. Thank you.